Welcome to the Photography News Show, where I bring you the best and latest news in the photography industry. Coming up today, we have the smallest 2x macro lens for full-frame cameras, a sensor as big as a grain of salt, and much more. So, let's begin! Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero, travel photographer and gear expert from Italy, and I want to welcome you to episode number 30 of the Photography News Show, my weekly series all about photography gear. And if you're into that, please consider subscribing to always stay on top of the industry. So, let's see what's new. Lens news. Venus Optics is a Chinese manufacturer which specializes in extreme lenses with great optical performance, such as the 10 to 80mm full-frame lens or the 24mm macro probe. And talking about macro, this week Venus Optics has unveiled the Laowa 85mm f5.6 2x Ultra Macro APO, the smallest 2x macro lens for full-frame cameras. It's just a bit more than 8cm tall and it's incredibly light, weighing only 259 grams, which is around half the weight of macro lenses with a similar focal length. When thinking about a compact and lightweight ultra macro lens, you might think image quality has been compromised, but Venus Optics engineers were able to give this lens an apochromatic optical design composed of 13 elements in 9 groups containing 3 extra low dispersion elements that greatly reduce aberrations. The images you can capture with this lens are very interesting, as you can reach a 2x magnification factor, which is twice what you get with a standard macro lens. Just imagine the level of details you can achieve with this lens mounted on a high megapixel camera. That's just insane. And talking about features, it comes with internal focusing to avoid collisions with your subjects, and it can focus from 16.3 cm to infinity, making this also usable as a portrait lens. Getting up to a 2:1 magnification factor in such a small package, together with no chromatic aberration, would probably cost a lot, right? Well, no. It comes at $449, which is a very interesting price to get a lens to explore the macro photography world. This lens is available for Sony FE, Canon RF, Nikon Z, and Leica M mounts, and you can grab it from the link in the description. Camera news. Camera manufacturers are constantly increasing the sensor's density. For example, the first consumer full-frame camera, the Sony Alpha 7, released back in 2013, had 24 megapixels, and 9 years later, the A7 R4 had 60. How about small sensors? Researchers at the Princeton University and the University of Washington have developed an ultra-compact camera the size of a grain of salt, which is capable of producing images that you'd normally get with a 500 times bigger camera. It uses a technology called the MetaSurface, studded with 1.6 million cylindrical posts. These, together with machine learning algorithms, are capable of rendering much higher quality images than in the past and will find great applications in several industries. But before we get too much into the future, let's take a step back to the awesome 90s. A few episodes ago, I showed you a Pepsi-themed Polaroid, while today, the same company released the Malibu Barbie Polaroid 600. I'm not sure who would buy that for $169, but it might be a cool gift to get your daughter into photography. While if you're on a budget but still want a somewhat new camera, you can get in touch with a wooden craft company from Vietnam, which is making some very realistic wooden cameras for less than 50 bucks. They might not be real cameras, but they could be something nice to have on a shelf. App news. Apple has introduced ProRes video on the iPhone 13 Pro and the 13 Pro Max, but how about Android? This week, I have for you the Motion Cam app, an open-source camera app that enables you to shoot 10-bit Cinema DNG RAW video. The company has shared the footage taken with its app, and I'm pretty impressed by it. As you can see, there's a whole lot more dynamic range than the one you get with the standard camera app. You also get full manual controls, and it can be a great way to get into videography without spending any additional money. In fact, you can download this app for free from the link in the description. Weird news. The imaging world can be at times weird. Christmas is approaching fast, so why not get a Canon teddy bear? It was announced this week by Canon USA, and it's a teddy bear with the Canon 5D Mark IV with a 24-70mm lens. It comes at $60 and it can be the secret weapon you needed to get your kid into photography.
Pictures of the week.
In this segment, I feature the most interesting pictures I've seen on the web. This week, I have for you the winners of the Hasselblad Masters 2021 competition. Among the over 63,000 images submitted, these are the ones that won the 12 different categories. The winners will get as a prize a Hasselblad medium format camera, not bad, right? And will also shoot for a collaborative project that will be published in a commemorative book. That's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. Which news did you like the most? Just let me know in the comments. If you have liked this video, please give it a big thumb up. Subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell, and share this video with your photography friends. And if you want to improve your photography, mindset, and productivity, feel free to DM me on Instagram or send me an email, and I will be always happy to help. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!